Attention! As you were. On this episode, we take a look at an epic war movie that stars half of 1998 Hollywood, with actors like Nick Nolte, Jim Caviezel, Sean Penn, George Clooney, John Cusack, Woody Harrelson, and many more. So let's take a look at The Thin Red Line.
I never bargained for nothing like this when I signed up for this man's army back in the Bronx before the war. How was I supposed to know there was gonna be a fucking war, huh? Answer me that.
Every duty station I had, there was always that one soldier who joined the army and didn't think there would be a war, especially in the 90s. Maybe it was for the benefits, but once 9/11 happened, you're definitely joining for war.
Colonel, I don't think that you fully understand what's going on out here. My company alone cannot take that position, sir. The Japs are too well dug in. They've got too much firepower.
Now attack, Snarls! That's a direct order!
Sir, I must tell you that I refuse to obey your order. I again request permission for patrol reconnaissance around to the right in force. The time, sir, is 13:21 hours, 25 seconds. I've got two witnesses here listening to what I've said. I request that you do the same with witnesses there. Over.
So by telling his commander that he has men monitoring their communications, what he's really saying is that he's preparing to file an official complaint about the orders. This is not a common thing, but sometimes the facts on the ground are different than they appear from the command's point of view. In this case, the commander wouldn't listen to the sit rep from his captain. And captain was correct in offering an alternative flanking maneuver before refusing his orders.
Azimuth 1470. From EZ Roger 7. 100 left, add 200. Left 25, drop 50.
Left 25, Uncle Baker 1. Left 25, drop 50. 5-4 effect.
In order to have effective indirect fire or artillery, you need eyes on the objective. First they call in a rough range, then using that info, they adjust rounds to within 50 meters. Then you call fire for effect, which means all guns are hitting in that area. Once you hear all rounds are complete, it's time for your assault. So this is a good example of how an eyes on danger close artillery strike should go. This is a perfect example of assaulting multiple bunkers. You need your support team providing covering fire that takes out enemy with small arms and your assault team with a lot of grenades to take out the bunkers. This is what they mean by when you hear violence of action. Boom.
We need to get out of here right now. You explain to headquarters. Situation.
No.
Do they know where we are? Because we're sitting ducks out here.
Well, I think that's up to me to judge, Sergeant.
Well, I think we just need to send somebody up there and find out how close they are. Okay? It's easy.
Hey, Weld!
Now, if you watch a lot of war movies like we do, then this is a common trope you see a lot. A good LT either dies or just gets replaced, and the new commander is incompetent. Now, this doesn't happen in the military a lot, but not nearly as frequently as the movies would lead you believe. Having served under a few different lieutenants, I could say that most, if not, we're all competent leaders.
What about... Broken up.
Shut up!
Well, he did what he set out to do and drew the enemy away from his men at great personal cost. What happens next boils down to choice. Do you want to be a prisoner of war or not? Now, for me in that situation, surrounded by enemies with no way to escape, I would have to take some of those enemies with me, knowing that I was going to die. What would you do in this situation? Leave a comment. Let me know. So this is a great movie. It's almost 3 hours long, but it doesn't feel that long. The pace of the action and character building, it's well balanced. There were no significant military mistakes that took me out of the action. All in all, this was a well-crafted narrative that I would recommend watching. Thanks for watching. Until next time, you're dismissed.